Begin with you. Do you know, as I have heard directly from people, Sarah has heard, Catherine Herridge has heard, and others, and Greg Jarrett, that in fact we have Rod Rosenstein threatening, intimidating, to use the power of that office to go after people in Congress and their staffs trying to do their job?
I believe it's happened, Sean. I've talked to folks who say it's happened who were there. So if in fact this did take place, which I think it did, this is the executive branch threatening staffers of a standing House committee trying to do their job and get answers for the American people. This is as wrong as it gets. And the fundamental question it raises is, will the Speaker of this House stand up and defend House Intelligence Committee staffers? And the best way to do that, in my judgment, is to bring up the resolution that the three of us introduced and Mr. Meadows and others introduced earlier today on the House floor.
I agree with you. Where is the Speaker on that, Congressman Ron DeSantis?
Sean, this conduct, if true, to me is disqualifying. He cannot be the Deputy Attorney General if he's threatening people who work in Congress simply because we're doing our job to try to get answers for the American people. And the arrogance of Rosenstein for months and months to stonewall nonstop, even basic answers, to redact information, has just gotten to the boiling point. We in Congress need to act. I think his position there is untenable.
What I am hearing, Congressman Gaetz, is that one of the reasons Rod Rosenstein is doing a lot of this is because there are specific documents with specific days and specific dates that may implicate him. Have you heard the same thing?
We have, Sean. Rod Rosenstein is intractably conflicted in this investigation. And as brave patriots like Kash Patel work hard for the Congress to expose the corruption and the bias, then they're threatened by Rod Rosenstein? This is outrageous. Kash Patel was in my office concerned for the fact that he, as a staff member, was doing his job and then somehow had a different branch of government bringing these threats upon him. So, I'm sick and tired of Rod Rosenstein's games. I think we need to impeach Rosenstein. He won't turn over documents. He signed a FISA renewal against the President of the United States. And frankly, if we don't step up and defend our institution, then what good is the Congress anyway?
Well, okay, and he has this temper, which I don't know if all of you heard about it, because you're all, can you shake your head? Because I've heard about it. And even, you know, I think Chairman Nunes is being pretty nice because, you know, I just assume he didn't want to go on the record, but to use that power the way we're talking about here. Here is what I'm hearing, Congressman Jordan. It's either going to be the president demands these documents or Congress has the option of impeaching him. And that would require the speaker to step up here. But more importantly, when do we get the documents and how does Congress do its job if they're being intimidated that they're going to be the subject of harassment and investigation as retaliation for Congress doing their constitutional duty?
Sean, you're right. There's certain tools we have in the toolbox. They should all be at our disposal to get the information we constitutionally are entitled to get answers for the American people. It's really that basic. I think this week there are kind of two fundamental questions. The first one is, the report comes out tomorrow from the Inspector General. It'll have people in there that'll be cited for wrongdoing. Will Rod Rosenstein fire people who are cited in the Inspector General's report for wrongdoing in the Clinton investigation? And then the second fundamental question is the one I raised before. Will the Speaker of the House stand up and defend people on House standing committees who were threatened by the Department of Justice? And the best way to do that is to bring up our resolution, and if they don't comply with the document request in that resolution, then to look for exactly what Matt Gaetz talked about. Contempt and impeachment are tools in the toolbox that we may have to go to. And finally, there's what Devin Nunes said, which is the president can say, release the information so they can get answers.
Last question, exit question, Congressman DeSantis and Gaetz. We'll start with you, Congressman DeSantis. Would it be quicker, better for the country that the president, that he demand the documents that Congress has been obstructed from getting? Should he demand them? Wouldn't that be the faster path?
I think so. Jim Jordan, Mark Meadows, and I sent him a letter a couple weeks ago urging him to do that. He has the power, and I think he should do it. The American people deserve the truth on this. Heck, Donald Trump has been treated as poorly as anybody by some of these jokers, so he should definitely pull the trigger on that.
Totally agree, Sean. Totally agree. Absolutely. You know,
right,
look,
guys.
The president has the power to bring this thing home. He can do it, and we're going to stand behind him.
All right. Thank you all for being with us. When we come back,
thank you.
Rush Limbaugh.